Good morning and thanks for visiting the RV Corral website. My name is Joe Murray and I'm a consignment manager here and I just wanted to take a minute today and tell you about this 2010 Adventurer camper. As you can see, it's just one of many campers that we have here available at the RV Corral. But today I'd like to highlight the 2010. It's an Adventurer. Model is an 86 SBS and stock number you can refer to is CM-185. That's CM-185. At any rate, this is an extremely clean one owner Adventurer camper. Probably a little more highline than some campers that maybe you've seen in the past. This has got a slide out, so you're going to have a lot more room for moving around inside, a lot more room for activity and for just getting around each other when you have to spend time inside the camper. Follow me and I'll show you some of the features. First thing that I'll highlight is that it's got electric jacks all the way around. They're remote electric jacks, so it's a wireless remote, one touch, so you can either raise or lower the whole unit with one touch of the remote, or you can go individually on each jack. It's the Happy Jack system, very popular parts for RVs. There's an outside shower, which is real nice for making sure that you don't drag the outside inside. All of your utilities, the outside of your refrigerator, water heater, and all that's right here. This is your cord for plugging into electricity should you happen to get into a park situation. Again, take a look at the outside, the fiberglass on this thing. The fellow that owned this is here on consignment, and the fellow that owned this had a great big shop, and he kept it inside his shop and showroom until the day he and his wife decided that they were going to move on and try something different. So excellent shape, excellent condition, no complaints about the appearance of this unit. This door right here, come on down, Curtis, this will open up and I'll show you two propane tanks. Again, take a look at even how clean the bay is. You can control those tanks from inside, obviously, and there's the on-offs here. As we get around the back, I want you to notice right away, you've got a ladder, so you want to get up on top of this unit. You can just climb back up. And let's start down at the bottom here. This has got a custom step system and a custom bumper system on it that most campers will not have. Most campers will come with an aluminum ladder, which, you know, aluminum steps, which will get you up and in and out of the unit. But this is a very nice, stable way to get in and out of this camper. They've also got a slide guard so that you got some traction there, a handle for pulling yourself up, make sure that you stay stable, and again a ladder which will take you up to the top. Also on the back of this unit, if you look up here, there's an awning, a fold-out awning. So as you're coming in and out of the unit or as you're camped, you can pull the awning out, make sure that, you know, if it's raining, you keep a rain on the outside. Good for, deflecting the sun as well. Come on around this side. This side, you can see the back side of the slide out room. Again, look at the top up here. There's another awning over the slide out. That serves the purpose primarily of keeping water from entering where that slide comes in and out of the camper. That's the biggest problem with all RVs is anytime you cut a hole in them, there's an opportunity to leak. And the slide topper, the slide awning like that, just rolls in and out with the slide out and protects the slide out and the camper, the coach itself, from getting water. Here's a big storage area. In the outside of the slide out, as you can see, he's got all the tie downs, your cable, extension, plugs, your crank. If your jack should somehow fail on electric, you can hand crank them. Any rate, again, take a look at the condition. You know, the stripes are in excellent condition. They're not faded or peeling. The doors all appear to close nicely. Follow me, we'll take a look inside. It's got a double lock system on the door. Got a window up top, and check this out. It's got a screen door also. So you open your door here. Now you got a screen door, so if it's hot in summer, you can still enter and exit and let a little bit of the outdoors in. After you, Curtis. I'm a big fella, so I'm gonna let Curtis go on in. First thing I want you to notice is how roomy this thing is. As you enter, right down at the base here by the rug are the buttons for the on-off, and there's also shut-offs for lights and so on and so forth. To your right, you'll notice the full kitchen. Microwave oven, a range with, let's see how many burners on the stove. 3 burner stove and an oven, so you can bake cookies, make the kids popcorn, and cook breakfast, whatever you need to do. Okay, it's got a nice color plan in here, and once again, a caring owner can sign this. And look, they even have the brochure from when the thing was brand new. The book with all the brochures from all the appliances. Nice window valances and shades. Look at these pull-down shades. Here's a Sirius satellite radio DVD player. Speaker control switch. Bar extension. So once you're cooking and everybody's kind of cozy inside, now you've got more room. Spread out your meal. Lots of deep cupboard space. Look how deep that goes back in there. So you can put the thing you really want. It'll always be in the back corner of your cupboard. But at least you got room for it. Over again, over here, take a look at the booth style seating. Again, very, very clean. I like the colors. Comfortable. You can put a lot of people around this. You get some adults, some kids, and you can pack the people in there as opposed to a, you know, 2-bench style dinette. It's also got window blinds on it over here. Pull down shades. Table's removable here, guys. So if all you do is remove the tabletop and this post, and you can, there's a filler board that comes in right here, and now you've got a bed, a big sleeping area for a second group of people. A couple of kids or even a couple of adults would probably be able to sleep here okay. You got a big double door refrigerator, freezer on the top, refrigerator on the bottom. That's a RV style refrigerator. That's a lot bigger than you see in most campers. Take a look up at the ceiling. You got surround sound. Okay, there's a vent here, so you can ventilate, get some air flowing through here. There's your lights here, another vent just up towards the front there too. And it looks like another one up over the bed. Before we get too far forward, let's take a look here. This is a nice feature. You've got an all-in-one bath here, guys. Look at this. So you can use the shower. You've got a toilet, should you find the need to use that. And a pretty large shower. You got a sink in here also, so it's kind of a all-in-one utility. There's a towel rack on here. It's, you know, it's everything you need. Oh, and there's a fan up in the top too, a little ventilation fan. So you get it steamy in there or something else, you can ventilate that right on out. A big queen size bed up front too. Got storage up over above. So everybody's got room, and then also you got storage. If you look down in here, you got storage for all your other stuff. You got one of those on each side of here, guys. Nice valance, shades back here. Throw pillows, that's how you do it, you throw them. And you're probably asking, what's this, Joe? Why is all this stuff on the bed? Okay, what these are, guys, is the owner of this camper wanted to have a place to store things when he was parked. So he would take the camper off of his truck so he could use his truck around the campground, around town. And these attach underneath the front overhang of the camper to make a small storage garage, let's say. So he put his generator under there, and he put his quad under there, and whatever else he needed, his coolers and so on and so forth. So one attaches to this side, one attaches to the front, and one attaches to this side. And you can see right here, they just slide right in a little groove. They hang down, they zip together on the corners, and these hold them together up front. So that's a very, very nice little extra feature that you probably will not find on any other camper that you're shopping. Check this out, guys. There's a big closet over here. Mirrored closet. So you can use the mirror for checking yourself out, and you can use the mirror to open it up and store your stuff. Plus, there's a little TV. Look at this. On a little swivel hinge. What's that? Probably about a 20-inch LCD. Looks like it's plugged in for the surround sound. So there's 2 more surround sound speakers up in the top here. So you can listen to your DVD player up in the front, up in the back, watch your television. If you don't want to watch TV in bed, this actually will I can undo this pin here, and this will come out and swivel around. You can watch it from the dinette. So lots of room for living, lots of room for cooking, lots of room for camping, and lots of room for you. So again, my name is Joe Murray. My phone number, if you would like to find out more about this adventure, is 541-912-8814 with the RV Corral, and I'm also the consignment manager. So if you have something you want to sell, please call me, 541-912-8814. Thanks for your time.